JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for September the 2nd. I am Charalambos Pissouros, head of research here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar traded lower against all but one of the other major currencies on Wednesday and during the Asian session Thursday. It gained fractionally only versus CAD, while it lost the most ground versus AUD, NZD and the euro in that order. Now, the weakening of the US dollar combined with the strengthening of the risk-linked Aussie and Kiwi suggests that markets may have traded in a risk-on manner yesterday and today in Asia. Indeed, taking a look at the equity world, we see that the majority of European indices finished their session in positive territory, while although sentiment softened later in the US, the Nasdaq managed to hit a fresh record high. The S&P 500 closed virtually unchanged, while the Dow actually slid somewhat. Market appetite was more on the mixed side during the Asian session today. Both Japan's Nikkei and China's Shanghai Composite traded in the green, while Hong Kong's Hang Seng and South Korea's KOSPI slid. Now, yesterday we noted that market participants may trade a bit more careful heading into Friday's US employment report for August. However, for some people, this may have not been the case, and the trigger for increasing their risk exposure may have been the miss of the ADP jobs report. The report revealed that the private sector gained 374,000 jobs, slightly more than July's 326,000, but way less than the forecast of 613,000. Now, following Fed Chief Powell's dovish Jackson Hole remarks, this may have encouraged investors to add to their bets over a delayed decision by the Fed to start scaling back its quantitative easing purchases, and may have also raised speculation that the NFPs due out on Friday could also miss their forecast. That said, we repeat once again that we are reluctant to rely much on the ADP number, as it is proved to be far from a reliable predictor for the NFPs. Even last month, when the ADP number fell to 330K from 680K, the NFPs held more or less steady around 940K. Now, as for Friday, the median forecast for the NFPs is at 750K, but the range of estimates is from 375K to 1.02 million, which suggests that analysts and participants do not have yet a clear picture over how the labor market fared during the month. In any case, the median forecasts point to another decent report, something that could revive speculation over quantitative easing tapering as early as at the upcoming gathering and may help the dollar rebound. The opposite could be true if we see the actual number coming closer to the lower bound of the estimates range. This could keep the greenback under pressure and allow equities to continue sailing north, as later tapering could also mean later rate hikes and thereby lower borrowing costs for companies for longer. Now, yesterday we also had an OPEC plus meeting, with the organization and its allies sticking to their existing policy despite being pushed by the US to pump more. That said, they revised up their demand forecasts for next year, which means that at some point they may indeed feel comfortable to increase production more. As for oil prices, they barely reacted on the decision, as it was well anticipated. Now, as for today's events, during the US session, we have the initial jobless claims for last week, which are expected to have declined somewhat. And we also get the US and Canadian trade data for July. As for the speakers, we have two on today's agenda, and those are Atlanta Fed President Rafael Bostic and San Francisco Fed President Mary Daly. Excuse me. So that's it. That's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 7 o'clock AM GMT. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again tomorrow.
JFT, just fair and direct.